I want to play Wind Waker. Hey, everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000, back with more Ocarina of Time! In the last episode, we got the Bigoron's sword, also known as the Bigoron sword, which has some very fun moves. Standing still, it has this huge horizontal swing. Moving forward, it has this really weird diagonal swing that's kind of hard to aim. What about moving backward? All right, moving backwards lets you do the standing still thing while you're locked on. And then for the side, we got left and right. And then the forward one is really satisfying, because basically, it's this stab. It's this stab-stab uppercut combo, but the stabs, Link steps forward like a whole bunch when he does them. And it's really effective, because first of all, the sword is like 2 meters long, and then Link steps forward an extra 2 feet when he uses it. Alright, anyway. We're warping back to the Temple of Time today because we're going back to being a kid again. You know, because it feels good to run again. Because we have business as a child. Because I find him, and then I grab him! I've got the child! I stole the baby from you, Dakini! When you were taking a pee-pee! Okay, anyway. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why I want to play Wind Waker all of a sudden. Wind Waker is a game that I have a very interesting relationship with, and by which I mean it's really boring, and I'm just saying it's interesting to make the mundanity of it a little more curious. Basically, I think I've played Wind Waker like 20 times and beaten it maybe once. I literally think I've beaten Wind Waker once, maybe twice, but I started from the beginning so many more times than I can count. And I just get bored somewhere along the way. I don't know why. Well, I guess it's probably not that hard to imagine why one might get bored of Wind Waker. I mean, there's a lot of dead air, and especially on the GameCube version, there's a lot of awful padding. Anyway, it's a really charming and cozy game. It's just like, I don't know, something about it is hard. It doesn't keep my attention like other Zeldas. Well, then again, not a lot of Zeldas actually can keep my attention. Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask can, because they're just the OGs. Link to the Past, I usually fizzle out somewhere around... my wallet is full. Link to the Past, I usually fizzle out somewhere around the, you know, like a little ways after I get into the Dark World, maybe. Or even before that, because there really isn't much to do before you get to the Dark World. I don't know. I feel like A Link to the Past, you have to go out of your way so much to build yourself up in the ways that make the game more fun. A Link to the Past is absolutely a game that is more fun the more powerful you are. But by the time you actually get powerful, by the time you actually reach those really high levels of power, you only have like another quarter of the game left to play around with them before you have to go back to ground zero on a new playthrough. Like, I wish there was like a new game plus mode for Link to the Past. That'd be cool. And Twilight Princess has just so much... Like, listen. I got nothing against Twilight Princess, but I wish there was a version of Twilight Princess that axed half of like the set pieces. You know, I wish there was a version of Twilight Princess where you could just, like, run around and you didn't have to worry about escorting those kids or, you know, doing any of that crap, you know? I wish there was a more open but still vanilla version of Twilight Princess that didn't have so much guff. What the hell? Did he just sneeze? Gross. Okay. So what we want to do now is come back here and play the Song of Storms in the windmill, which I don't know if this is clear, but basically we got the Song of Storms from this guy in the future, and he said something about like, oh, that rascally kid played this song in the past, and then you had to go back and fulfill the time loop or whatever. And that's your hint, and playing it causes the well to drain. Don't ask me how that works. To the ground, rain is falling all around. La, 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 la. How you feeling? Go around, go around, go around. What? It's going way too fast. Yeah, this thing is so fast you actually can't fight the speed of it when you're just walking. At least along the outside. You can fight it on the inside because, you know, diameter, circumference, speed. Lightning speed! Anyway. So now now the well is drained, and we can get on to, and we can enter one of the freakiest areas in this game. One of the areas in this game that I can't, that, like, you almost can't believe exists because of how freaky it is. This is the bottom of the well. With scary Zora mouth, all I don't want with the scary music. I love this area. I used to like dabble in DMing, and I don't think I'm cut out for it. At least not unless I like. I'm pretty sure I have ADHD of some repute. And I don't think it helped me when I was trying to DM. You'd think some variants of OCD might help with, you know, with that, but I don't think ADHD would be much help in terms of DMing a consistent campaign. I mean, ADHD is almost classified by its inconsistency. Anyway, I DM'd a campaign that only lasted about 3 sessions, and the first dungeon, basically the dungeon was like, I did like kind of a Tartarus thing where, like the dungeon, they had like a base, and the dungeon they were delving into was like one big giant dungeon that went down really, 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 really far. And the first floor of it, like the first stratum of it, I based on this area. Careful around this X in I'm not sure what this thing is, but I think it's supposed, I think it's actually some kind of like a medieval torture device or something. This place is fucked up, man. There's blood on the ground. There's this X that I believe is some kind of torture thing. I mean, there's bodies and gore everywhere. Like, that can't be overstated either. Oh my god, hi. Jeez. It's so weird. Like, as a kid, I tunnel visioned so hard on the skull of the Skulltulas that I never even realized that they had, like, spider eyes. Okay, anyway, our first order of business in this dungeon is this thing back here. The water flowing out of this statue is flooding the entire floor. Yeah, it's, like, scary. Oh my gosh. So, simple the royal crest here. Just play the Zelda's lullaby. Just play the Zelda's lullaby. And maybe we can do something here. And that'll cause the water to drain. That water didn't even look like it was flowing. I'm gonna break this pot. I break a pot. Oh, I got a bomb from it. You can actually kill this big bubble going around in circles here. All you have to do is hit it with a boomerang. And that'll stun it. It's a green gobble, and only takes one hit too. It's kind of funny if you actually let it hit you though, or not let it hit you, but if you have the Hylian shield, you can just turtle and it'll pass right over you. But it'll hit your shield like 50 times as it does. Like, bring! It's really funny. Anyway. So yeah, this area is pretty spooky. I think when I adapted it into a D&D dungeon, I put the water draining later because I think it's kind of a bummer how early you drain the water here, because like you don't get to explore the dungeon much while the water isn't drained. I don't need bombs, dude. I got plenty of bombs. Now, you know, on a normal playthrough, I would have been like halfway through here already because of the gimmick of this place, which is, basically, well, I don't want to say what it is, because, like, not knowing what it is half of, is literally, like, half of the progression. Like, not knowing what you're missing in this dungeon is literally, like, the entire point of what you're missing in this dungeon, is stuff that you don't know. Because the shadow stuff in this game is based around illusion. So, yeah, this room is kind of dangerous. Basically, you have these six coffins here. It reminds me of the green ghost. I'm getting green ghost flashbacks. Something scary comes your way. You get cold shivers, don't run away. Coffins make a lovely home, but someone's green and all alone. Watch out, look out, here he comes. We can't stop the green ghost from going after you. Each plot was scary and was go mysteries, running from a going with the flow. Someday you'll never count on. The way he says "you will never count on" in the song is just so. It sounds like he's dying, man. Okay, so anyway, all six of the. Anyway, all six of these coffins have something in them. I believe it's the back left one that has a key in it. Yeah, this dungeon actually does have keys, you know. None of the other child dungeons had key. I love that they actually make you do this as a kid, by the way. It just makes it even worse that they make you do this extremely... What the hell? Jeez. You didn't see my ass. Good lord. I'm all the fucking way over here. Oh lord, he coming. That's a Gibdo, by the way. They're basically... Yeah, in this game, they basically... just made Gibdos into shitty Rita. Can I light you on fire, actually? With my Deku Stick? Or are you just gonna, like, grab onto me? Like, what if I just, like, rolled past you with the Deku Stick? Okay, that didn't do anything. Oh, I opened that one, too. I wasn't even, like, thinking about it. Ah, so many bats! I'm now intimidated by the number of bats! What is that guy doing? Oh, God, hang on. Shit! Okay, fine, I'll put the healing shield on. Yeah, I would've lost my Deku shield. Sure enough. Okay. Oh god! Okay. Piece of dog shit hit the... There we go. That guy out of here. You can actually burn those guys. If you use Din's fire, I think fire arrows might also work. You can use that to like burn their bindings, and then unlike in old Zelda games where they would become Stalfos, in this game they become Rededs if you burn off their stuff. If you burn off their bandages. So there's one small key. There's one special D small key. The reason I say that, special D small key, is because there was this guy, I think it's Shofu, like, a competitive Pokemon player, who, like, when he says, when he's talking about, like, something, a Pokemon having high defense, he says that they're, he would say that, like, they're special D bulky, and the way, and, like, his accent made the bulky come out, like, B-O-K-Y, special D bulky. And now whenever I say small key, I think of that, so I say it. It's so stupid. Anyway. I guess let's head over this way. I could open that other locked door, but I know I can't... I shouldn't be able to get what's behind it yet, so I'm gonna open this one first. Which is just a... Ow! Which is just a Deku Baba. And some shit. And a Skulltula! I don't know how many Skulltulas there are in this place. I'm gonna assume maybe not that. I'm gonna assume not that much. But I have no idea, honestly. I have no idea how many Skulltulas there are in this zone. I guess you might be wondering why I haven't gone for this chest yet. Well, I guess I'll show you, huh? Oh no! Ow, 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 ow. Get out of the acid, man. That's this dungeon's deal, is, everything is fake. There's fake floors, there's fake walls. Oh, man, I got the, glitch. Sometimes if you, like, if you do a jump attack with a Deku Stick, and you break the Deku Stick at, like, the right frame in the animation or something, that'll happen. Like, the Deku Stick will break, but you won't let go of it, and you'll be able to keep using it. But I don't know what causes it. Seems pretty random. Anyway. There's a lot of stuff down here in this bottom area. This is basically a big giant hand. This room down here that we're in right now is basically a big giant hand. Oh, Christ. Can I hit you with the boomerang? Nope. I might be able to hit you with the sun song. Yeah, thankfully the jump attack hits those guys twice. I don't know why. Maybe it's just because they're tall. I believe this is the map. Yeah, so now you can see the bottom of this room is all swarthy looking and freaky. Man, I really want to record some Oot Rando today. Because, I'm like, you know, I think I'm like 11 hours in now, and I'm making steady progress, and it's been fun, and I've been enjoying it, and I really want to record more, but I hurt my throat last night. I had these, like, butterflies in my stomach for some reason that I couldn't figure out, and I ended up getting rid of them by taking a jog, but it was minus 27, so, like, I ended up hurting my throat from, like, breathing in ice-cold, like, frigid air a whole bunch. Then I got on COCOM with Tim for, like, half an hour, where I was pretty mellow, but, you know, I was still on COCOM for half an hour, and that... Now I'm paying the price. But I can't just stop recording. I can't just leave you fine folks with nothing to watch, because I'm sure you have literally no other YouTubers you've been meaning to get around to, you know? I mean, oh my god, how egotistical is that, like, whole, I have to upload once every day or my followers will have nothing to watch. It's like, dude, if your followers are that desperate for your content, they need to get some, you know, they need to find some more things to watch. Like, nobody should be that dependent on one person to entertain them. Also, as a kid for the longest time, I thought these were like some sort of acid flowers. They're arms. You can actually stand on them, which is kind of funny. Okay, that was a bit too far. So that's messed up. Dude, I didn't want to do that. Oh, they're like wooden, too. That's creepy. Okay, well, did I pick up all the silver rupees down here? No, there's one up the ladder. Anyway. Yeah, so there are pits like that one that I fell down to get to the chest. There are pits like that all over this dungeon. And the only way to see what you're doing in this dungeon is to actually go and... Man, this is weird. Do you really fight the mini-boss first in this dungeon? Is that really what the game expects? Because it is, isn't it? Because, you know, this dungeon doesn't have a boss, per se. This dungeon is basically just like a little mini-dungeon, a little prelude to the Shadow Temple that you do as a kid. But this path right here leads to the mini-boss, or the boss, I guess, which is one of the freakiest things to ever exist in a Zelda game. Like, when you see this thing, if you haven't seen this thing before, then get ready, because this shit is the stuff of nightmares. I should see if G wants to do anything with this design, because it is seriously one crazed-up Fruit Loop. Oh, God. Ugh, look at those nails. Well, actually, the nails bring to mind a certain Miss Resident Evil Boobs McFerguson, so that's fine. What the hell? Oh my god, what the fuck is that thing? It's the dead hand. Watch out for its infinite hands. Aim for its head. What the fuck? Can I hit you with bombs? You don't give a shit about bombs, do you? Yeah, this thing, oh god, it's so freaky. It just, like, why does it walk like that, you know? Why does it walk with, like, its head tilted up and its long giraffe neck pointing straight up and its little, like, chicken wing arms wiggling back and forth off of its fat bod? It's like, there's nothing okay about this. Why is it covered in blood? Why is it pale? Why is it bloated? Ugh. I'm getting this thing out of here as quickly as I can because I don't want to look at it. I mentioned this in the randomizer, but I actually wrote a poem about this guy in school once that the teacher wouldn't let me submit for, like, the poetry assignment because it was too... Because either the poem itself or the artwork I chose was too creepy. Oh, hey, thank you, Navi. You know, I never really realized that, but she totally, like, points out to you what direction he appeared from. I feel like a lot of people don't give Navi the credit she deserves because they forget that, she's the person who basically handles Z-targeting. Oh my god. Yeah, that's what you want. That's what you don't want to happen. You don't want this guy. Can you play the Sun Song against this guy? Maybe. I'm curious. No, that didn't do anything. I didn't really expect it to, but I thought, you know, it's worth a shot. Get out of here. Oh my god, you're not dead yet? Ugh. Thank you. Oh, and then when he dies, he collapses on the ground like that, and he twitches for, like, 15 full seconds before finally disappearing. It's like, as if it wasn't bad enough. Ugh. Man, I wanted to get a look at his face there. Oh, well. In here, we get the dungeon item. How weird is it to get this right away? Well, guess what, you know? We're already done here. Like, this is all we actually came in here for. I'm not even sure why they give you this so early. What is the point of doing the rest of the dungeon from here? You literally don't need to do any of the dungeon. Like, after getting this. The only mandatory parts of this dungeon are playing Zelda's Lullaby and fighting this guy. This, like, the door in here isn't even locked. Anyway, there's a huge rupee there. I could have spent my money on something and gotten that with an empty wallet, but frankly, I don't give a damn. I'm pretty sure I'm pretty much out of things to spend money on. So, yeah, I couldn't care less. What is that a comment on? Someone just liked a comment of mine, and I don't know what it's on. Oh, Fortune Street. Right, yeah. Birdo's in Fortune Street. I need to play Fortune Street. I've never really played Monopoly, but... that game looks interesting. Anyway, we're up to, like, 23 minutes. Should we end this here? It's kind of an awkward place to end the episode, but it boggles the mind. Why do they give you that so early? That's all you actually need out of this dungeon is the Lens of Truth. So, because Lens of Truth lets you see fake walls, like this one. I didn't even comment on it, but when we came out of that underground room, we walked through this wall, and we found that, and we found ourselves here. That's what this does. It shows you the truth. Like, there's an opening right here that brings you to a chest. And there's openings all over the place. There's lots and lots of openings here. Yeah, I think I'll clean up the rest of this dungeon now, because I might as well. Then we can get started on doing... Well, no, you know what, actually? I'm not going to do that right now. I'm going to end this episode right here. Oh, come on. Stop being this stupid Skulltula interrupting the music. I'm gonna end this episode right here, and next time on Ocarina of Time, we will finish up the bottom of the well, and then I think what we'll do is we'll go and see if there's any Skulltula cleanup we can do as a kid. So look forward to it. I'll see you on the other side. Bye. Scary, sore mouth all wide open.